Hello again. Thank you for joining our meeting today. Today I would like to talk a little bit about how to send emails in Cloud UX via SAP Business One. We have a few things on our agenda. First, I would like to talk with you about can use my local Outlook. What do I need to do for mailing? How to configure mailing in Cloud UX? What has changed in the mailing in Zap Business One 9.3? And we will take a quick look into Core Suite and B1 Up and how you can there configure the mail servers and how you can use them in Cloud UX. Okay, so let us start with the first topic. Can I use my local Outlook? That's the only answer, no. There's currently no possibility to connect your local Outlook with Cloud UX. So the only possibilities you have is to use the SBO mailer on the Cloud UX environment or the mailing functionality from third-party add-ons. There will be some developments from third-party add-ons at the moment that maybe that you can in the future connect your local Outlook with Cloud UX, but this will be then extra functionality and is not working out of the box. Okay, what do I need for mailing? For mailing, when your customer or when you want to, as customer or as partner, want to do mailing via Cloud UX, there are two options. Since 9.3, you have the possibility to set up the mailing set up per tenant on your own. In the previous versions, we had to do that for you. So that always was the case that when you opened an incident to ask, okay, how do I configure mailing? That you got an email like this example here, where we ask you to provide us an SMTP account, which we can use to create a rule on our SMTP gateway that you can use then or your customer to send emails out of Zap Business One. This SMTP gateway or this SMTP account needs to configured like this that because we only can configure one rule in our gateway per customer. So this SMTP account needs to be configured like this that all emails you want to configure on Zap Business One for each person which is using Zap Business One needs to authenticate needs to be authenticated against this SMTP account in our SMTP gateway rule. So the for example for Office 365 there's an I think it's called sending as functionality so that you configure this SMTP account that has all the permissions to send in the name of other email addresses. So I will go to SAP now quickly. So since 9.3, SAP added a functionality in the system initialization general settings. Under the services tab, you have now the possibility to configure per tenant the mailer. In the past, there was only one mailer for the whole in the cloud, it's called service unit. So for all databases in one environment, and therefore we had to introduce this SMTP gateway because otherwise only the sub SBO mailer has only the possibility to provide only one SMTP account and not for each single customer. So in the 9.3, as of 9.3, you have the possibility to configure it on your own. So you don't need to ask CloudX anymore to configure an SMTP rule. So now you are able to do it on your own. So enable the checkbox, enter your SMTP credentials, and then you will be able to do this. The good thing is with this configuration, you can do it for each tenant individually. So for example, when you do it, you have a German and a US company and both using a different domain name, for example. So then you can do your configuration here like this, that the German company will get the German SMTP server and the US company the other one. So that's so you can do it very dynamically. So the other thing is here the default email method you only can use inside CloudX Sub Business One Mailer. The Outlook email will not be supported. So we had already some cases there that the email configuration or the email server does not work correctly with the with this new mailer functionality, which what SAP introduced into 9.3. So therefore, we can do, of course, create a rule in our SMTP gateway again, and then you just need to disable it here, and then our SMTP gateway will take over. So it's if you have some issues with this functionality here, we can use, of course, a fallback to our SMTP gateway. I will go now and start the first add-on. So I have started Beyond Up now. We have here a standard configuration. So Beyond Up is not really configured in detail. So it's just now only for this presentation now. Where do I have module configuration? And then print and delivery report action we have configured here now. The email report, and here we have configured the SMTP delivery method. And here you can see now that in this case, because my email address, what I used for this demo preparation, is not working properly with this add-in. And so therefore, we decide, okay, we use our SMTP gateway. So this is the server name of the SMTP gateway. So it's sv-jr-p-hmail. And it's working on port 25. But this is only working for you when we have created the rule. Otherwise, the email will not go out from there. What I said before, so you have always a possibility to enter your own or directly your credentials into the configuration windows, but you have also the possibility that we use our gateway to send the emails. As I said, it's just a standard configuration. So when I go to sales, AR invoice. And I do send an email. So the B1 app will take over and will send directly the email out. I have here my mailing account and can see here now he has delivered it with the with our SMTP gateway. Let's go back to SAP. This is the same configuration you can do, of course, also with the other add-on like CoreSuite. These are just two examples how you can configure them. But I think you as partner and customer are way more experienced in configuring the add-on with the style of how the email will look like when they go out to the customer. So it's just an example to show you how we can use our infrastructure to send emails. Here again. Here will core systems then take over. And when we go into the configuration, then you will see here as well that we used here again the our SMTP gateway. So with my demo email address, I had this issue, but we made good experience actually with the Office 365 servers that you can enter them here directly without creating an extra rule on our gateway. Are there any questions? So you don't need to unmute your microphone. You also can write it into the chat window if you want. So there are many times the question if we provide Outlook on our terminal servers, there is also the answer no. We did it in the past, but due to security reasons, we don't do that anymore. And so also, for example, last time there was a question if we provide, for example, other email clients, there's also the answer no, because due to security reasons, we can't look into the email accounts. And if you receive, for example, some kind of email malware, which will encrypt your terminal server, so we can't prevent that, because we can't look into it, because it's encrypted already when you receive it on the terminal server. But when the email application will receive it, it's already encrypted to SSL. So and we can look into it. So so that's the reason why we decided to not support it anymore. And back to Outlook. Outlook is also another story because of some license regulations from Microsoft. They will make it very hard to install it on our terminal servers. So we decided not to do it anymore. So there are no questions. Oh, there is. Okay, that was the answer My colleague answered their question. Okay, Olaf, was his question answered?
I don't see any question.
Okay, because you wrote something in the...
That was just a summary from what you told, just to have it also in the chat for everyone to copy paste in case they wanted.
Okay, I thought there was a question somewhere hidden that only you could
see. It was just to everyone to see. Okay, to explain a little bit in written what you try to explain in words. When an SMTP account is configured in SAP or in our gateway, it doesn't make any difference. The account that is configured needs the permission to send as, well, example, Michael at Wodecki.de or Lisa at Wodecki could also be order and invoice and something like Wodecki.de to be able to use this email address in the SAP.
Exactly.
And the other one, I prepared some other sentence also, just to have it in the written chat also. So it's always a good idea if your customer is, or if you are using SAP 9.3 in CloudIAX, or you have add-ons like CoreSuite or Boyum, it's always a good idea to try the direct configuration yourself in the SAP, in the add-on, to send out the emails before asking CloudIAX to set up the rule on our gateway. There are some advantage for you because you don't have to wait for us. You can configure it completely without us. You don't need to give us the information like the account data and the password because customers don't like so much to provide login data with username and password. And in the end, we don't. In the end, I'm happy if I don't know the password. So that's the reason you always should first try to configure it in SAP yourself or in the add-on yourself. And if it doesn't work, then we still can do it by our gateway. And if customer don't want to provide the password, it can be set up. We prepare the gateway, everything. And in worst case, we do a remote session and the customer can type in the password itself. So I don't know it. But it's just complicating the whole process and taking more time probably than doing it yourself. So that's always the best idea and the best way for you to support your customer.
Right. Okay, so if there are no questions, I have two additional hints I would like to show you. The first thing I would like to show you is our new help page. If you go to the CloudIAX.com webpage, we have on the right corner here a help link now, which will lead you to our knowledge base. And here you will find. So we are constantly adding them this help page with new content. Also about technical things like how you can connect to HANA Studio, SQL Studio, how you can, for example, use Crystal Reports. How do I need to update the data source location, and all the things. And so if you have an issue or maybe a question, maybe it's a good idea to look first into it, into this help page here. Then, of course, if you don't find your proper answer, you can open an incident. But we also have the possibility, or we also provide since a few months that we placed all our webinars also on our CloudIAX.com page. And here we will find also the webinar from today in soon. And so we find already the German version you can find already here. And also how you, for example, last time we talked about printing, how you can configure printing and how you can do Crystal Reports configuration. And we will also constantly filling this page with new videos and to help you to understand how CloudEX will work and to give you better support. Then the last thing I would like to show you is a status.cloudex.com page. This is the actually our heartbeat. And here we will always find information about if CloudEx is working properly or are there any issues. You can see here on the top if there are some global incidents open at the moment, and are there any maintenance plan for the next time frame. And you will also see here then all our systems, and you will see here if they are available or not. If you want to get this information, if you, for example, let's say there's an open incident and you would like to get an information about it automatically, you can subscribe an email newsletter, and then you will also get this information via email. Okay. Thank you very much for your time. And I hope to see you next time. And thank you for your attention. Goodbye.